Brown pelicans are amazing seabirds. They live right here in the Chesapeake Bay.
My name is Autumn-Lynn Harrison, and I am a research ecologist with the Smithsonian National Zoological Park and Conservation Biology Institute. We are in the middle of the Chesapeake Bay. There are some historic islands that once housed hotels and casinos and entire communities, and now are amazing breeding colonies for many types of water birds, including brown pelicans. My family has been on the eastern shore of Maryland since the 1600s. So I thought, you know, this is the place I would really like to work and discover some of the amazing animal migrations that we have locally here in the Chesapeake Bay.
My name is Dave Brinker. I am the state of Maryland's colonial nesting waterbird biologist. It's been my whole career out here. I'm the fortunate individual to find the first brown pelican nest in the state of Maryland back in 1987. The Smithsonian is bringing an ability to do something that we would love to do, and that's put high-tech transmitters on brown pelicans to get real detailed information on how they use the Central Bay. We want to have a healthy community of water birds. That's everything from gulls to terns, herons, egrets. And when pelicans moved into the bay, it made our community more diverse. It meant that the bay was in good enough condition that we could add a large fish predator to it. And they've done well. They've gone from the first few nesting birds to now there's probably 2,500 to 3,000 pair that breed in the Chesapeake Bay system every year.
This brown pelican colony is the northernmost brown pelican colony that we know of. There are pelicans nesting in South Carolina and Georgia and the Gulf of Mexico. So our work here will fill in the last piece of the puzzle for the migratory connectivity story for brown pelicans in North America. We find a nest where a brown pelican's nesting. We set up a trap at the nest. We capture the bird. And then we bring the bird back to this processing station. We do a number of morphological measurements. And then we attach the transmitter to the bird. And it will deliver data to us via satellite. Because these islands are so historic and they had families living on them, we decided to honor the memory of those communities by naming individual pelicans after the family names of people who once lived here. We hope the tags will last for a full migration for a year. The tags that we are deploying this year are designed to fall off ultimately. It's collecting GPS positions every couple of hours.
One of the really exciting things that we've already discovered about brown pelicans here in the Chesapeake Bay is that they make it all the way down to Cuba to spend the entire winter. I'm really excited to get a window into the secret lives of brown pelicans that nest here in the Chesapeake Bay.